Hey everyone, it is a gorgeous Friday afternoon and we are headed south from Conway down to Ridgeville, South Carolina, which is near Summerville. We're staying at a Hipcamp called Natural Gathering Grounds. We stayed there last year. It was our first Hipcamp we ever did and we loved it, so we're going back.
A Hipcamp is basically just like Airbnb for glamping and camping, but we'll put a link in the description down below.
What do you think? Are y'all ready for an adventure?
Let's go!
Let's go! So excited. They're going straight to the swings. Hip camps are all very different. This one is one of the bigger ones that we've stayed at. You do know, just like when you search for an Airbnb or a hotel, you know what you're getting into and you can see pictures and reviews before you come. So that helps a lot.
One of my favorite things about this place is it has a lot of cool swings. Hold on so I can get on the other swing over there.
I got your shoes, kid. Here you go. Look at his feet already. Look, show Daddy your feet already. We've been out of the car for what, 10 seconds? Last time we stayed in the tents, which was really fun, but we're very excited that this time we don't have to set up a tent. And we got this camper, which is called Ramble On Rose, and the pictures looked super cute. So I'm hoping that it looks like what the pictures look like. So let's check it out. And we have a gnome home. So all around Natural Gathering Grounds, they have all of these little homes for you to find
and look,
for
right here.
Gnomes and fairies all over the place. All right, let's see.
Oh my gosh, it's like the cutest thing ever.
Okay, let me go. Ooh, there are lights. Okay, so that's good.
Oh! Jeez. This is like the cutest thing I've ever seen.
Oh yeah.
I love this.
When you first walk in, there's a very nice mirror so you can check yourself out. There is a restroom, but it says do not use the restroom. So it's a very funky, vintage looking restroom, but we are not supposed to use that because there's a note that says there's no running water. Don't use the sinks or the tubs or the toilets. Use the bathhouse, which I knew that from when I looked it up. So there is a sink, but you can't use it. We do think that the coffee maker might work and there's filters and things. So that makes me think that it does. And then they did give you some supplies like rags and foil and some plates and things like that. Pretty sure the stove doesn't work would be my assumption, but they do have some cups and cutlery and things for you to use and some disposable ones back there too. There is a fridge, but that does not work. Now there are a couple things up here and we're assuming if you plug those in, they would work, but we're not sure. The lights turn on, so that'll be nice in the evening. And then there's also dividers, so you can kind of section off your space, which is really nice. And the bed seems really comfortable. They do give you extra bedding supplies over there as well. This is super cozy and nice. And the temperature feels great in here. The other half of the camper also has a divider, which is awesome. And this is where the kids are gonna sleep. It's a very cozy corner for them. I love how they decorated and all the bright colors is really cool. And then there's heat, electric. So if we need that, which it is supposed to get chilly tonight, so we'll see if we need it, we'll feel it out. And then again, more blankets and that kind of thing. And there's a lot of light coming in, which is nice. So yeah, I'm very pleased with this. It's very open and big, so I'm excited.
Careful.
It seems bigger to me maybe because I'm not as tall as Scott is, but he definitely just backed up.
And... yeah, I'm going to find that in the middle of the night.
Oh yeah, 100%. Now you got your own room. See how that works?
Oh my gosh, I love
that. Say bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you. While there's no one in the bathhouse, I'm gonna show you around. So there's three stalls on the women's side. And then three showers. There's benches and places to hang your things, but it is pretty open over here. And then three sinks.
One of the easiest things when you get to a campsite and you don't want to start up the grill or the fire, warm up some queso and get some nacho chips and toppings.
Delicious. Isla and Holden are snuggled in for the evening. What are your thoughts on the camper?
It's awesome. It's like a hotel, but with wilderness. It's like home sweet home.
It's like home sweet home. And they have their little setup, so they're watching a movie, getting ready for bed after eating all the sugar from the s'mores.
So yummy.
So say, see you in the morning.
See you in the morning.
See you in the morning.
Wait, baby.
It's a nice chilly morning. It's about 45 degrees right now. We all slept so well in that camper until Scott said he heard someone woke him up at 5:09. This guy. Scott's got breakfast going. And my, there he is. Who woke you
the
up?
The evil cockerel.
The appliances that they provide do work. So we had pre-made some biscuits, so we're gonna cook those up. Breakfast in bed. It's a good way to start the morning. Oh, Skyla made a Sammy. That was smart. My absolute favorite thing about being at a campsite is morning coffee and a morning fire.
When you were here with the other family, right.
That's the pond house over there. We might try to stay at that one next time.
So, Skyla, did you find the gnome home city?
This is the Sunshine Shack. And this is where our host for Natural Gathering Grounds said she caught a couple of fish yesterday. And then we also found our first...
gnome home.
I can see a fish in there waiting to be caught. Go find it! I think the bird bath's my favorite part of this one. Home to the gnomes.
Oh my gosh, it fell over.
We're gonna have to help him out.
It's weird.
Skyla wants to help this house out.
Good.
Yeah. She's the interior designer. Let's see, did you fix it up? Very nice. Much better. This is the path out to the river. Not sure how far we can get because we know it's flooded at some point. I know, I really want him to dive. Ooh.
Looks like a snake.
Don't say that, Holden. A swan snake? Now y'all are making me freaked out by this bird. That's skill right there. It's like a weird version of tightrope walking.
Gotta really puff your belly. Ow!
Holden, do you think that the swamp thing is about to pop out over here?
Oh, like from Teen Titans Go?
No, no, like, well, I guess maybe, but I'm talking about like old school monsters, Swamp Thing.
When they kind of go out like that.
Yeah, that's the thing from Teen Titans, and it's really good in that, so yeah.
Okay. Let's see what you got.
I'm in.
Epic.
Even better.
We found another swing over here.
It's really fun.
And then there's also a baby swing, which is great. This is where you first pull in. And so the white structure over there is the pond house that you can rent. Straight ahead is the main house. The path that we just took to walk and find all the gnome homes is back in that direction, and that would also lead you to the river. And then the farm is that way. The easiest path over to our camper is right next to the farm. And then the bathhouse is right here. This is the main house in the farm area. And then this is where we're staying in this area over here. And then we just did the walk around this area. And we weren't able to get up this path, but there's the river and they do have a dock back there. But this sunshine shack is where we showed you could do some fishing. So there are still options even if you can't get all the way to the river. Are you trying to will it in with your mind power? Or are you gonna give it a little nudge? On the menu, there are some really good looking appetizers like Gouda mac and cheese bites, camp rolls, which are shrimp and grit spring roll with tasso and pepper jack cheese, ahi tuna nachos. There's a couple soups, and then they have a lot of platters or salads, so you can do catfish, shrimp, scallops, oysters, flounder, or chicken. And they all come with fries, hush puppies, and mayo slaw. And then they do have some entrees like shrimp and grits, a po' boy, fried duck legs, and the fried fisherman's platter, which is flounder, scallops, oysters, and shrimp. The last time we were here a year ago, they had the best soft shell crab sandwich. And they said that was the special yesterday, but they checked and they had some, so they're gonna do that for us. So I was really happy that we asked about that.
Soft shell crab sandwich, one of our favorites. You can't always get it everywhere. The fries are amazing. They're Old Bay fries, handmade, homemade. Good looking flounder. Skyla's dream, fried bread.
And how's the hush puppy?
Awesome. As good as cookout.
Oh, that's a high praise coming from you. And Daddy was so nice to give you the claw. Are you gonna try it?
I'm gonna eat this.
Is that some good crab?
Yeah.
Everything was incredible, basically. The fish, the soft shell crab sandwich, was so nice of them to do that, even though it wasn't technically on the menu today. Skyla got a massive plate of chicken tenders for her kids' meal. The mac and cheese was delicious. I think my favorite were the sweet potato tots. It just kind of depends what you're in the mood for, but every side was so good. We just came into the visitor center in Summerville. This is the bird sculpture trail, and we're gonna do that, which is really fun. This tells us about all the sculptures at Azalea Park, and then this tells you about the historic homes in the area.
Hashtag birthplace of sweet tea.
Thank you.
playing poo sticks.
Or do you want to do it?
I'm going to do it. How did I play against
So we're going to count down. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Drop. Okay. Now you got to come over to the other side. Slowest game of poo sticks ever. But Skyla wins. I see it coming.
Yeah, there it is. I win.
They give you a tour map and they tell you all about the different historic homes. When we were at the park, it's easy to kind of walk the path and look at all the homes, or you could easily just hop in your car and ride around too. We're starting the bird sculpture trail. We probably won't find all of them today. There's 23. And so they give you these clues and then they give you a full map. So in case you can't find it, you can see exactly where it is and what it looks like. To our birds, corners are all the rage. So heading down there would be most sage. While clinging to trees, this tiny bird sees. You search block by block and page by page. And the kids already found it. Where is it?
Right
above us. To mid-block now, continue your search. There you'll find a hole-in-the-wall church. A life of new lease through this bird of peace. Look up there or be left in a lurch.
There you go. So you got the
hole-in-the-wall church.
Yeah.
Where is it, Skyla?
It's right up there.
Yeah.
They're setting up for some live music. And we heard that last night there was another live act as well on Friday evening.
Now is the time to find our state bird. Up to the corner, at least that's the word, on a store of drugs, this eater of bugs has now made you a bird watching nerd. And this pharmacy, it says since 1871. So I think we should go in and take a look.
This building on the corner is actually, they said it's the oldest pharmacy in South Carolina.
And you can get root beer floats here too.
Yeah.
This is the world's largest sweet tea. It's 2,524 gallons. It's a lot of sweet tea. Amazing. How is it?
Oh, really good. That's really good.
We got a red velvet milkshake. It was, I think, $7.50 for the mega size. And normally we wouldn't get something like that, but since we're on a trip, we got it, and it is so worth it. This is really, really good. Scott got some horchata. I just grabbed a pork taco and some street corn. Because it was free, randomly.
Yeah, I stumbled upon it. It was sponsored by a mortgage company that's paying for the food truck to be there. Might as well.
We stopped off at Gihvans Ferry State Park because it's only a couple of minutes from Natural Gathering Grounds. We have the state park pass, and one of the things we like about that is they always have a playground. So even if we're just passing through on any road trip, we always try to make sure that we stop at whatever state parks are along the way. And they usually have some kind of pretty water to look at. So that's always a plus too. We're back, buddies. We missed you. Hi there. Hi. Look at you. Oh my goodness. That's some good balance right there. Are those some good flowers? All right, Holden, hide like Skyla's coming. Is it comfy in there? Whoa, you can like stretch out that whole way, that way too. Looks like you're inside of a parachute.
It finally got warm enough for me to take my hoodie off when I realized I forgot to take my toothbrush out.
The kids are eating the popcorn that they got from Simple Treasures today in Summerville. And which flavors did you get?
I got cotton candy.
Is that one piece? And what did you get, Holden?
Strawberry.
They're both very pink. One of the really nice things is that not only do they have this little grill, but they even had the charcoal ready in it for us. Which is a nice touch.
Mm-hmm. We brought our travel toothbrush. Grill brush. It works.
But you only brought a 1 cup measuring cup and not a full measuring cup because
no,
we needed to save space.
A quarter cup.
Oh, you brought a quarter to save space. We brought a quarter cup. So yeah, 9 times.
We needed 9 times.
To make some rice. Got some asparagus cooking in the fire.
Got a couple sausages on. And then had some pork chops marinating.
Nice.
Say hello to my little friend.
Oh, hang on. Hold your hand still. Oh, don't put him on me. Hang on. Whoa. What's his name?
I named him Flash.
Okay.
You can go back, Flash.
Where's his home?
You can go back.
We got some rice, pork chops, asparagus, roasted tomatoes.
The last morning fire. Sad times, I don't want to go home.
Yep, we've got coffee, toast, smokies, and eggs going.
These are Holden's favorite. It's Sunday morning, it is 50 degrees, and it's time to take a shower in the bathhouse, which is not a heated building. So we'll see how it goes. The kids took their showers last night and they said it was hot for a little bit and then got cold pretty quick, so I don't know if they were being dramatic or not, so I'm gonna test it out.
They do have this little heater in here, so I am cranking this buddy.
I had a very different experience than the kids. I think it might have hurt them that they were showering at the same time, so they might have been stealing each other's hot water, but for me, I had a nice hot shower. The bathhouse itself was of course cold, but having that little heater was nice as I was getting ready. So yeah, overall, success. All right, this is always a sad part. We gotta say goodbye to the camper. Giving it some love.
But at least we're saying hello to a new adventure.
That's a really good way of thinking about it. Let's go.
Saying goodbye, but yeah. We're saying hello.
All right, let's head off. Daddy's already driving away without us.
Oh gosh.
Oh my goodness, you better chase after that car. Go, 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 go. We'll put a link in the description down below to where we stayed specifically at Natural Gathering Grounds, and so you can get some more information about Hipcamp. If you've never stayed at a Hipcamp, we highly recommend it.
Yeah.
It's a great way to camp, and we like to look for the glamping options now, where you can just kind of go and everything's already set up for you. And where we stayed at Natural Gathering Grounds, there are several options. They do have primitive tent camping, normal camping spots that are numbered. They have the camper, they have the pond house, and then they also have the big main house. I don't think we mentioned that, but you can also rent that out, which would be great for if you had a couple families.
Yeah, I think it sleeps 10 or 12 people. So another option as well. Perfect. And that's a great thing about Hipcamp. You never know what you're gonna get, but they describe them really well. So they have something for everybody.
Keep checking out our videos and keep adventuring.